If you've ever wanted to know what Capstan Drive is, I'm going to explain it for you now. Using as an example the Webcor Microcorder 300 reel-to-reel tape recorder. I'm currently restoring this machine and had to take it completely apart to get to the belts and replace them. So this gives me an opportunity to show you what a capstan actually is. This wheel with its shaft is the capstan assembly. Usually they're made of one piece, but sometimes they'll be made of several pieces somehow hooked together, either forged together or with screws, set screws, or other means put together. In this case, it is an assembly because it contains pulleys and a geared tooth wheel and a bearing for operation. The capstan itself is the steel shaft that you see here, and when you look on a tape recorder that's capstan drive, you will always see this shaft somewhere on the machine. The hidden part that you never see is the flywheel, which is this round section here. The holes that are drilled here are for balancing the flywheel. The purpose of the flywheel is to provide inertial force, dampening, and gyroscopic motion so that the tape is pulled smoothly across the heads and that any variation in the motor and the belts is evened out. The capstan flywheel has a back bearing on it in this particular machine, which sits in a socket located here on the deck. And it is kept in balance by sitting through a bushing located here in the upper plate, which is upside down right now. And when you remove it from the bushing, it's completely free. To show you gyroscopic motion, I'm placing it in its little socket, and I'm going to spin it for you. And you can see how it spins quite freely, and this will continue spinning for quite some time because there is a ball bearing at the bottom of the thrust plate. Basically, the capstan always rotates in counterclockwise rotation, like that. The motor here has a belt that goes around the capstan flywheel, and that's what drives the machine. Very often in these machines, all power is taken from the capstan to drive other parts of the machine. You will also see on a capstan drive tape recorder a pinch roller, sometimes called a pressure roller. It's a rubber roller, and when the machine is put together, the roller presses against the capstan shaft, pinching the tape, which is why it's called a pinch roller. And as the capstan shaft rotates, because of the pressure roller, it pulls the tape evenly across the heads. And that basically is the story behind the principle of capstan drive. Always remember there is a shaft, which you will always see on a capstan drive tape recorder, and some kind of a flywheel, which you won't see because it's on the inside of the machine.